When Arizona police searched this abandoned KFC, they found a secret cartel tunnel hidden inside. As they walked through the dusty rooms of an abandoned KFC, the Immigration and Customs Enforcement officers probably had a good idea of what they'd find inside. After all, by now, finding secret cross-border tunnels in Arizona is a regular occurrence. But this was not a normal tunnel, and what it was used for is of serious concern for officials. Fried chicken chain KFC is second only to McDonald's when it comes to global fast food sales. In fact, it was among the first American chains to franchise internationally. But now it has nearly 20,000 stores all around the world, with almost 4,500 of those in the US alone. But franchising stores doesn't always work out. Indeed, it's not uncommon to see restaurants close, no matter how successful their parent companies are. Once upon a time, you could grab a bucket of chicken within sight of Mexico in the city of San Luis, Arizona. But for reasons unknown, that KFC store closed several years ago. However, its location, just 200 yards away from the Mexican-American border, means the abandoned building remains in a notable spot. It may have come as no surprise then when the Department of Homeland Security's Investigations Division received a tip about the abandoned restaurant in April 2018. Indeed, the information they received suggested that there was a tunnel going directly into the old KFC joint. As a result, the local authorities began monitoring the building's owner, Ivan Lopez. Fast forward a few months, and the Border Police pulled Lopez over on a routine traffic stop. A sniffer dog pointed them in the direction of his trailer, where they found a pair of toolboxes, and each was filled with illegal substances. This discovery then drew the officers' attention to the abandoned KFC that Lopez owned. The officers quickly discovered that Lopez had bought the KFC building back in April 2018. In total, it cost $390,000, which he had paid in cash. As things began to look suspicious, the Immigration and Customs Enforcement agents applied for a search warrant for the defunct fast food restaurant. Armed with the warrant, the ICE agents made their way into the one-time KFC. And when they reached the kitchen, they found something distinctly out of the ordinary, an 8-inch hole in the wall. Upon closer inspection and using some effort to chip away the area around the opening, they realized that the hole led into a shaft. It wasn't long then before they discovered the true purpose of the opening. It was a tunnel to Mexico. Indeed, the shaft led down into a passageway that stretched to nearly 600 feet. On either side, hundreds of planks of wood shored up the walls, creating what was ostensibly a sophisticated underground path. In fact, at 3 feet wide and 5 feet tall, the tunnel was so big that a person could walk right through it. And if they did, starting at the opening of the restaurant, they'd end up in a home in Mexico, on the other side of the border. More specifically, they'd find themselves at a trap door underneath it. The apparent reason for this cross-border tunnel was one familiar to the authorities. Indeed, it's believed that the tunnel was used for smuggling narcotics, partly because of the illegal drugs found in Lopez. Indeed, the value of the contents in the toolboxes was around $1 million. Due to the tunnel's size, authorities believed that the individuals involved in drug trafficking would climb down through the trap door in Mexico, walk the length of the passage, and deposit the narcotics in the other end. Then the drugs would supposedly be lifted through the tiny opening in the abandoned KFC with a rope. This isn't the first tunnel of its kind, of course. Indeed, HSI Special Agent Scott Brown told the Associated Press in August 2018, "Tunnels are a time-consuming venture, but they've definitely increased since border security measures have ramped up." Brown also pointed out that increases in infrastructure, resources, and patrols have forced smugglers to look towards these costly tunnels. Indeed, a serviceable tunnel can take eye-watering amounts of money and manpower to construct. According to Brown, cartels can spend into the hundreds of thousands building the tunnels. And it's not a quick job either, requiring an extensive number of hours to build each one. The government believes that Lopez, the man arrested in conjunction with the KFC tunnel, is a prominent cartel member. He's also considered likely to attempt to flee from justice. Indeed, legal documents say that he's being held in prison without any kind of bail offering while awaiting criminal charges. Even if tunnels are generally becoming more common, there was a difference with this particular underground passageway. Indeed, the substances that authorities seized in relation to it were all hard narcotics, according to Brown. I think that's what makes this tunnel a little unique, and frankly a little more scary than some of the other ones we've seen, he said. Meanwhile, Richard Jessup, the town's chief of police, told the Washington Post that the surge in tunnels is not surprising. After all, San Luis is Arizona's largest border city, and a pair of huge fences measuring 20 feet tall block above ground access. Of course, if you can't go over the wall, you go under it, he said. Indeed, according to the UK's Independent newspaper, authorities have uncovered around 200 tunnels over the past three decades. In fact, the KFC tunnel was the fifth of its kind in that region alone since 2007. Brown told the Washington Post, generally, along the southwest border, every couple of months, we're encountering a tunnel. While most of these tunnels are left unfinished, some aren't. Indeed, every now and then, officers discover a passageway that's outfitted with concrete flooring, ventilation systems, and even power lines. But they can be easy to spot. Indeed, all the earth that's excavated to make them has to go somewhere after all, and a large deposit can lead officers straight to the source. Yes, the KFC tunnel certainly wasn't the first of its kind. In 2016, agents discovered a tunnel in San Diego, California that was nearly half a mile long, ending in Tijuana, Mexico. And it's even not the first to start in San Luis either. Indeed, a case in 2012 found a passageway that linked the Arizona city with San Luis Rio, Colorado in Mexico. Nevertheless, the tunnel shooting out from the abandoned fast food restaurant is still a noteworthy addition to the long list of instances along the border, mostly because of the huge weight of hard narcotics seemingly transported through it. And of course, because a secret cartel tunnel isn't exactly the first thing you think of when you picture KFC.